9. We want to get our first check of the forecast with meteorologist Sam Ryan, who is in for Ken Barlow today. A much quieter day.
It is, yeah. We started off, it's kind of humid and almost muggy feeling early this morning, but now we're quickly becoming less humid, much cooler today with cloudy skies and highs only topping out in the 50s. And we're also going to have a stiff westerly breeze at around 15 to 25 miles per hour. The good news is the winds relax as we head into the overnight. The sky's clear, and that's going to set the stage for a half of a nice weekend. I'll fill you in on all the details on that coming up.
All right, sounds good, Sam. Thank you. We talked about those spring storms. They dropped a tornado in south central Minnesota yesterday, but thankfully nobody was hurt.
Now we have video of those storms and pictures of the damage that it's caused. Catherine Johnson has been looking into the storm reports this morning. Catherine.
Yeah, guys, we know this morning at least 3 reported tornadoes touched down in southern Minnesota yesterday. That included in Madelia and in Lake Crystal. The first, though, was spotted taking shape over near St. James. It formed really quickly, just a few miles out of the small town, and then hit just before 5 o'clock. A storm chaser caught the tornado on camera as it pummeled farms and fields in the area. Now, the tornado's track narrowly missed those homes, and thankfully, no one was hurt. The storm then spanned about 70 miles to the east, with high winds knocking power lines to the ground in Waseca. And we met up with weather spotter John Wetter. Yes, he has the perfect name for someone who spends his free time chasing storms, and he is one of many who act as the eyes and ears for the National Weather Service when they're out in the field.
There's a lot of great technology, faster computers, better systems in place now, but that just can't replace actual people out in the field seeing what the storm is actually doing.
And as you're waking up to any damage in your area, please remember you can always send us your pictures at pics@kstp.com. Now, coming up in the next half hour, we're going to be hearing from the man who first caught that tornado touchdown over near St. James, sending that confirmation out so people knew to seek shelter right away. Live in the newsroom, Catherine Johnson, 5 Eyewitness News.
And make sure you stay ahead of the storm by downloading our KSTP severe weather app right to your smartphone. You'll get alerts, you'll get weather watches, warnings wherever you are. This app is free to download for iPhone and Android.
We know the weather did have a pretty big impact.